Hi there, Marius here with the Resuscitation Coach. In this video, we'll be reviewing the ACLS Bradycardia Algorithm based on the 2025 American Heart Association guidelines. I will include a link to the algorithm in the description below. The Bradycardia algorithm outlines the steps for the assessment and management of a patient presenting with symptomatic bradycardia with a pulse. The algorithm starts with the identification of bradycardia, which is a heart rate less than 50 beats per minute with significant symptoms. The primary decision point in the algorithm is determining whether the bradycardia is causing the patient's signs and symptoms or some other illness is causing the bradycardia. The symptoms of cardiopulmonary compromise includes hypertension, acute altered mental status, signs of shock, ischemic chest discomfort, or acute heart failure. If the bradycardia is not causing cardiopulmonary compromise, then identify and treat the underlying causes. If the patient has adequate perfusion, observe and monitor. Support the ABCs, consider oxygen, and obtain a 12-lead ECG. Once bradycardia has been identified, ensure that the airway is opened, maintained, and protected. Check the breathing rate and saturation, and if hypoxemic, provide oxygen or assist breathing as necessary. Check the heart rate and blood pressure. Get the monitor on, identify the rhythm, and get IV access. Obtain a 12-lead ECG if available. Consideration should also be given to possible hypoxic, myocardial ischemia, electrolyte abnormalities, or toxicologic causes as well. If the bradycardia persists with cardiopulmonary compromise, administer atropine 1 mg. Classified as an anticholinergic drug, atropine is effective for the treatment of certain types of bradycardia. Atropine typically will not work for a second degree block type 2 or a third degree block, or high degree blocks. If atropine is ineffective, consider transcutaneous pacing, dopamine, or an epinephrine infusion. The American Heart Association lets you choose which one you would like to use. In general, it's much quicker to start with TCP and then, as you're busy with pacing, to start preparing other infusions. Transcutaneous pacing uses electrodes on the chest to deliver electrical impulses that override the heart's normal pacemaker function. It's important to know how to set up TCP with the device you have available. Dopamine stimulates the beta-1 adrenal receptors, resulting in improved myocardial contractility, increased SA node rate, and enhanced impulse conduction in the heart. If the patient does not respond to atropine, TCP, dopamine, and epinephrine, seek expert consultation and prepare for transvenous pacing. At any point, if the patient goes into cardiac arrest, immediately follow the cardiac arrest algorithm. For more information, please review the 2025 American Heart Association guidelines. Link in the description below. If you benefited from this video, kindly like, subscribe, and smash that notification bell. We'll see you in the next review video. Have a fantastic day.